Welcome back to my channel, friends. This side Sonia here from Growing Craft, and I hope you guys are able to see me. I am just trying to connect and see if we can start with our today's session. So what we have today is an old chalkboard, and I'll just wait for a few more people to join us and let me see how many of you join us, because this is going to be really interesting as we had not planned for any of the session today. It's just that today only we thought of coming and doing a session for you all. Yes, if you have joined us just now, don't worry, you have not missed anything, because I have not started doing anything till now. It's just that I'm drying the base what I had done. Hello Shilpa, hi Nimisha, hi Gunpreet, and I'm sorry if I missed out the previous messages. Hi Bhavna, hi Mamta. Hello everyone, and I hope you all are doing good. I really really hope that you are doing well. Now I know you all are aware of all the basic steps of decoupage, so, and the mixed media. I hope that is clear, because we have been doing that since long. And yes, I wanted to move a little more ahead and try out something new. So let me see if few more people can join us so that I can start explaining. And till then, what I'm doing is I'm just trying to make sure that I add some good texture on my base. And hi Sunita, hi Veena. Girls, I'm really sorry if I'm not able to answer your messages, but once we are done with the session, I promise I am going to reply back to all the comments. I will surely do that. I will surely do that. If you are following my page, you must be knowing that now we have been like started replying to all the comments. We are trying our level best. Like, trust me, I don't want to miss out any of the messages. Yes, today is the chopping board. So yes, I was requested a lot to do something on the chopping board, and my messenger is full of chopboard requests, so I thought why not to do this. And today we have a chopboard. Now what I have done already is I have added a coat of gesso to it, the white gesso, the heavy gesso. And yes, I have used this heavy gesso on my chopboard. And after that, now here with my fan brush, I am applying my modeling paste. Now you must be thinking that Sonia has gone crazy, why she's applying her modeling paste like this. Like, it's weird, I know, but we wanted to try out something new and something different. And yes, please do share this video as much as you can, because it is going to help us. And yes, of course, just to show you, if you have missed out our recent video on our YouTube channel, that's this mixed media chalkboard video tutorial, then please do check. I have kept the backside just to show you that this was a plain MDF base, and on that we have done this mixed media art. And I'm sure you are going to love this tutorial, because the way I have done it is something which I'm really proud of, and I absolutely love this one. So yeah, can you see all those textures? And yes, once you check my YouTube channel, you will be able to see that we have used all the scrap pieces for this masterpiece. So do check our YouTube channel. That's in the name of Growing Craft. Okay, now moving on to the another project which I really wanted to share with you all is this one. So this was a mixed media art which we did on one of our workshops. So yes, if you want to join our workshops, please connect with us on WhatsApp or on our YouTube channel or on our website www.growingcraft.com. Okay, now this is a plastic chalkboard. I really did not wanted to show you the backside, but I will have to show you. So this is how my old chalkboard has been lying with me for quite a long time now. So I thought of giving this a makeover. Now I have just done a white color gesso on the base. Now what I'm going to do is I am going to use my wood grain tool. I have already mentioned the link on the my Facebook page. You can check that. And yes, please do not forget to follow our page. Now I'm going to use this. Now this has two options. One is to give the nice wooden grains. The other one is this one. I love this part. This has such a beautiful lines. I think this is visible now. Yeah, so I'm going to use this to create a beautiful background. What I'm going to do is I will just run this on my chalkboard. Can you see the nice grainy part? I hope this is visible. Yes. Do let me know in the comment section if you like this video. And yes, do not forget to check our YouTube channel. That's in the name of Growing Craft, where you can see almost 600 videos. Yes, you heard me right. We have almost 600 videos on our YouTube channel. So you can check that so that you can learn decoupage, mixed media, scrapbooking, card making and whatnot. Oops. I'll just clean this up right now. So yes, I will just repeat the process again. So first what we did was a white color gesso on the base, and then what we have done is the modeling paste. I just applied my modeling paste, and then I have done my wood grain tool part texture. I'll just show you this tool. So this is the tool which I have used for this texture effect. Let me just show you this with a close-up. Okay, now this looks gorgeous, and I hope that this looks beautiful too, because I'm putting so much of effort and so many of you are watching us right now. I can see 400 people joining us for our live session, and this is such a pleasure for me. And yes, in this we are going to do mixed media and decoupage, both the techniques. So you will have to stay till the end of this session. And yes, for the previous sessions winners, we are going to announce that tonight on our YouTube channel. That's Growing Craft. So what you need to do is you just need to search for us on YouTube and check out. Now, of course, this project is something which I absolutely loved. The base was from Priya's Art, and I thought of doing a mixed media art on this one, and I created this beautiful piece of art. So yes, if you have missed out any of my videos, you can check them at Growing Craft on YouTube. And yes, we also have our goodies for sale at a giveaway prices. So do check www.growingcraft.com. So today we are altering an old chalkboard. Let me just show you that how my old chalkboard was. So the front was even the worst, and this was the back side. It was this horrible, and I had stopped using this one. So what I had to do was I have to do something decorative, something beautiful, which I can use it, or maybe I can give this as a giveaway. I'm not sure. It depends on how you guys respond to this session. So let me decide. Okay, so first I have done my gesso work on this one. Now after that, my white gesso, I have done my modeling paste work. So the modeling paste what I've used is this Montmartre modeling paste. Then I've used my wood grain tool, and now I'm using my heat gun to dry out. Thank you so much, Amy, for your kind words. I absolutely love this. Trust me, last month I was not able to take like live sessions so frequently, and I was missing you all so much. I was really missing you all, because Mondays and Fridays, like, of course I have butterflies on my stomach when I know that I have to take the live sessions. I am so scared every time that I might do some mistake, something might go wrong. And of course I have done, and you guys have been so good to me that you have always shared me with your love. Okay, now here I am, almost done. Now this is the modeling paste. That's the reason it is taking so much of time. And yes, we have posted our website link here. Do check that, and I'm sure you will be loving that too. Okay, now let this dry out completely, because otherwise we can't do our work on this one. Now what I'm going to do is I'll just keep this, actually I can keep, just keep this aside. Okay, now this is one of the napkins. As you can see, this has already been used once. So what I will be doing is I'll take up this side, and then same paintbrush and water technique which I always do. So here I have a container in which I have a water. I am going to dip my brush, and I will just make a nice border so that I can trim down all the excessive parts of this beautiful Buddha piece. And very quickly I'm going to take it out. Okay, very quickly, very quickly we will take this out. Why we have to do this quickly? Because as it's a tissue paper, it is going to dry out very fast. So you just need to keep that in mind. Okay, now again I'll use my heat gun on this just to make sure that it dries out well, so that I can remove the plies here. Okay, now I can see some of the shades on the sides, but it's absolutely fine. And yes, I was able to remove the plies so quickly. Why? Because I have used my heat gun and it saves so much of time. Now, as you all you know that we always do the decoupage work on a flat surface, but I love doing it on a textured surface. And I could create this texture surface because of my tool, which I had shown you at the starting of the video. Of course, now we need to stick this. And for sticking this, I highly recommend this Mod Podge. This is one of my favorite. And yes, this is not a sponsored video. So whatever I'm using here is, of course, by choice, and this is what I really wanted to share with you all. And I hope you will learn something good today, and I hope you will enjoy this. I'm just trying to dry this a little more so that when I stick my napkin, it should not come out at all, and it should not smudge to my base also. Yes, if you have not checked our more than 500 videos, like we are going to touch almost 600 videos now. So yes, for that you need to check our YouTube channel. That's www.youtube.com/growingcraft. Okay, now with a flat brush, I am applying my Mod Podge. And I know that how much area is required. So I'm going to cover up that much part with my Mod Podge. And yes, this is a matte finish Mod Podge, which I absolutely love. So I always prefer using this as compared to any other decoupage glue. Of course, I'm not saying that the others are not good, but this is what I like using a lot. Okay, and now we are going to stick this. I hope this is at the center. Okay. Yeah, I think this is almost at the center of my page. Yeah, so this is done. This looks great. Now what I'm going to do is I will take up another brush and I'm going to press this. Now if you remember, we have not used the plain surface. So today we are doing decoupage on a textured surface. So many of you have told me, no, you can't do this. This is not possible. How will it work? It works absolutely fine. And let me show you. Okay, now check this. Now here in this part, can you see the lines? Now this is not visible here. Oops, sorry. Yeah, can you see these lines? These are because of the texture work what we have done. And this looks absolutely beautiful. Okay, now what we are going to do is we are going to press this really well and a little quicker. Why? Because we have to do so much of work. We can't leave this panel plain. If you are at Growing Craft, then you will have to be assured that we are going to do loads of karani. Okay, I just ruined my decoupage napkin, and like I always tell you that I do some blunders and you guys always support me. So today we are going to learn something that when you ruin your decoupage napkin, how to fix that. I hope that is going to be interesting for all of you because no one is perfect. I'm not perfect. I'm still learning. I am still, every day is a new day for me when I come and try out things in my craft room and I go so crazy when I do some blunders. But I think that's the fun. Like if everything is perfect, then what are we learning? No. I do lots of blunder. And yes, just in case if you have not joined our Facebook group where you can show your artwork, then please, please, please do join us. That's also in the name of Growing Craft. So we are there on Instagram, we are there on Facebook page, we are there on YouTube channel and everywhere. Trust me, everywhere you can find us with just the name of Growing Craft. Now let me pick up some of the blue shades and of course I am going to make it easier for you by blending different shades and that's going to be really really fun. Now I have picked up three different colors, okay, chalk paints, acrylic paints and another chalk paint, and we are going to blend this one. Now let me just use my heat gun once again. This is just to make sure that everything has dried out well so that we can start using the colors. Also, I will need a brown shade to cover this up. Okay, now this part is clear. This is the portion which is there. This was not there in the napkin itself. So what I'm going to do is I am going to use my blue brown color acrylic paint. Now, here is my acrylic block. I'll just take some color here. Okay, a tinge of brown color. I'll just add thoda water to it. But before that, let me add some more water here. Okay, and now I am going to color this up. This is just to make sure that it looks like a one piece of art. Not by adding too much of color. We will have to be a little careful. I hope the screen is visible and I hope you all are able to hear me. Okay, and I'll just to touch up on the parts where I just ruined my napkin, and I'm also going to cover up the bottom part. Now here, as you can see, I always seal up my decoupage napkins with the varnish, but here I have not done. Why? Because I wanted my napkin to absorb some color. Okay, now wherever I want a darker shade, I'm not adding my water to it. Thanks, Rupa. Thanks, Rupa Biani. I am actually loving this, that you guys are liking this one. And I hope that I will be able to do justice to this chalkboard because this has been lying with me for quite a good month now. And I had to give a makeover to this one. So yes, now you can't even make out that I have done the brown color painting separately, and now I'm just doing a very very quick try so that we can move on to the next step. And let me just show you a close-up of this one. Yeah, can you see the lines and grains? This is all because of the background texture work what we have done. Now we need to seal this before starting our other work. Why? Because we are going to play around with loads of color and I definitely don't want my beautiful Buddha image to get ruined. So here I'm using my water-based varnish and literally I am going to dip my Buddha ji with the varnish. Why? So that when we use any of the blending solutions or the coloring or any other mediums, it should not ruin our napkin at all. Okay, so it happens with everyone. Someday if you just ruined your project because of something, do not throw it away. Try out something new. Try out to cover it up. Try out to use whatever you have to seal that up. And I'm sure you are going to love that. Why? Because we all do mistakes. It's a human nature. I always do, trust me, whenever I'm shooting a, whenever I'm making a tutorial, I do loads of blunder and I always show that in my videos that, see, this is what had happened and this is what I have created. Okay, so here we are done with our varnish coat. Just one coat of varnish. Now again I'll use my heat gun. Please do share this video as much as you can. That's going to be a great help for me. And of course, I am going to reply back to all your comments. Of course, I will try to do that as soon as possible. Now, why do we seal our decoupage napkin with a varnish? You can even use your Mod Podge also. I love doing that with a varnish because then it adds a little more strength to your page. And then your color blending techniques and your other mediums work become much more easier. The napkin does not absorb all those things. So that's the reason I like using my varnish. So the varnish what I have used here is an Asian Paint varnish. Let me just show you guys. So this is a varnish which I use, and I highly recommend everyone to get this one. This is an interior varnish, and you can use this for any of your decor pieces, and it works perfectly. Now let's move on to the next step, and that's the color blending technique. And let me add some more colors here. I'm just thinking of having, suggest me which color we should play with. I have decided that I'm going to use blue. Which one? Which should be the next color? Let me, okay. I think I've decided on which oral colors I want. I'm thinking of teal blue and then some maroon shade to it. So what we are going to do is, now this is my fan brush. Let me take up a container of water. Okay. Now I'll just dip this on my texture work. Do not overdo the water. Why? Because it's a modeling paste. We have not sealed that up. So it might ruin your project. It might ruin your modeling paste work. So please don't do that. Okay. Now, very quickly, I'll just brush up all the colors. And yes, I have added water to it. Why? On my base, because I wanted to give a nice shading effect to it. Now I'm using my acrylic color, I'm using my chalk paints, and I'm going to blend all of these, and trust me, it looks gorgeous. Okay, now I will just brush it up on the corners and wherever it is possible. You can always take out the excessive color, and you will not believe me, this whole grainy thing is because of the modeling work what we have done. Now here I feel that I had the excessive blue color, so I'm just going to dab my napkin to take out the excessive color, and you can see that how painted this looks now. Okay, now let me add my sky blue color. Okay, and we are going to blend this also. So yes, you don't have to have so many shades. If you have a darker shade, you can add white color to it and then play around with it. It's absolutely fine. So yes, do not worry about how to get so many colors. If you have a lighter shade, add some darker shade to it. It is going to change the color, and yes, of course, it is going to make it look beautiful for sure. Okay, now on the sides, I'm just going to dab some of my light blue color, and of course, I will be blending some with my darker shade too. So I'll just dab some dark shade, and I will make it a little, like I'll try to give a little shadowy effect on the sides. Okay, now can you see the difference? Can you see here? I have not done the shadow work. Like I have not used my darker shade, and here I am doing it. This is just to create a nice shadowy effect. Okay. Very small amount of color. You do not need too much of color here at all. Okay, now on this part I could realize that my napkin is visible too much. So I'll just blend this with my color, and I'm almost done. Okay, now can you see? this looks gorgeous. Let me add some more shades here, and let me also add this background. So what I'm doing here is I'm adding my brown and blue color. This is just to make sure that it gives a nice shady effect on the background. Now here, if you will see, can you see my acrylic block? I have blended my brown color and my blue color. Now these two are my acrylic paints. I am not using chalk paint here right now. Of course, I have done some of the chalk paint work, but I'm blending the colors right now. So what we did is we did the gesso work on the base, and then we have done the modeling paste work, and then we did our decoupage work, and now we are just highlighting our textures. So now with this technique, we are not doing the proper coloring work. What we are doing is just the highlighting of our texture. Okay. I'll just run my brush like this so that it can give you a nice blue and brown darker edges, and this should look good, right? It depends on how you are using your brush, how you are running your brushes. That makes a huge difference. Okay, let me just highlight this cut. I hope this is visible. Okay, not too much of brushing, and here we are done. So yes, this looks gorgeous and beautiful, and this looks absolutely beautiful. Now still we have to play around with some more supplies. So what we need to do is we need to dry this up, and for that I am going to use my heat gun. Yes, if you have not checked our YouTube channel, please check that. That's in the name of Growing Craft. And yes, you can find us on Instagram, on Facebook, on Facebook group. And yes, if you are a crafter, please do join our Facebook group, because we are coming up with monthly challenges on our Facebook group, and I hope, and I really hope that you are going to love that too. Now the next tool which I absolutely love using when it comes to my decoupage and mixed media art is the sponge dauber. Now these are one of my favorite tools which I highly recommend to everyone. If you are into mixed media, if you are into decoupage, then do try these tools. They work perfectly. Now I need to add a little more darker aid, so I'm just dabbing this on my acrylic block. Let me keep this here, and now I will be giving a nice shady effect. Can you see this? Just a tinge of shady effect, and this is creating a nice border. So why we did the earlier the bluish color on the top, so that we don't have to do overdo of the brown color. I hope this is visible. This is just to give a nice border effect to our chalkboard. Now can you make out that this was a chalkboard? Yeah, let me know if you could make out. Okay, I'll add some more acrylic color. Just take a tinge of color on your sponge dauber and dab it on the edges. Make sure whenever you are holding this, you are not overdoing the pressing work. Why? Because it is going to ruin your base. So yes, you will have to be careful when you do this. Okay. Yes, we are done. We are almost done. Let me just cover up this blue brown color. Okay. Now we will be doing this border work on the sides also. So every time I used to use the MDF bases, you were like, can we do this on any other surface? Yes, you can do the same technique on any of the bases, and it works perfectly. Now I will be giving some border work here, and now Vani Agarwal is here standing next to me. Vani, do you want?
Hi.
So yeah, that's Vanya saying hi to everyone out there. Okay, now I will be just dapping this on my base. This is just again to highlight my grains. Okay, what I've done is I've taken up the color, the brown color, and I'm just rubbing this on my texture work. This is to make sure that my colors are getting highlighted so much. My texture work is looking beautiful, and I hope you are liking this one. Okay, you don't have to press this at all. What you need to do is just dab your colors and rub this very gently. So whichever the texture part is there, it is going to get highlighted. If you want, you can just dab this very, very, very gently if you feel that it has not worked out. Now on the edges, I'm going to dab it a little more just to make sure that my colors have blended well and to have a little more darker edges. Yes, if you have any queries, you can always connect with us on our YouTube channel. If you have not checked our YouTube channel, where we are about to reach 600 videos, and yes, all those videos are absolutely free. And yes, we are also open for the workshops. If you want to join our workshop, you need to check www.growingcraft.com and you can find all the details about our workshop. And this looks gorgeous. This looks pretty. So I just want to show you the back side so that you guys have an idea that how my board was looking earlier. Like, the back side is still the plain. Let me dry this up quickly. Hi Sonia, you are so late today. Thanks Nadia, I'm so glad that you like this. Yes, I'm missing out on so many messages, but then I am going to reply back as soon as possible. Yes, what I have used here is a tool, the wood grain tool for the texture work. I will be sharing all the supplies link the moment I'm done with this session. So you will have to stay tuned on our page 2. Now at last, I just felt that I need to add some of the colors here to highlight my Buddha a little more. Just I'm dabbing my paint brush on the sides and this looks gorgeous now. Okay, now again I will use my heat gun and thank you so much, Rajshree. Thank you so much. Don't worry, Nehal. This video is going to be there on our Facebook page forever. So you can watch this again and again. And if you are creating something beautiful, please do share with us on our Facebook group. That's In the Name of Growing Craft, where we love seeing your projects. Now, the last thing is to add some more shadow work. So for that, I'm using my black color acrylic paint. And I will be using this Anukul paint brush, which I love using. I'll just add some water to it. Now, I will have to add a little more water to it. I will have to make it a little more liquidy. And now I will be just doing a bit of shadow work. And yes, I will have to make sure that I apply a generous amount of water so that it looks much more natural. And of course we need to repeat this on our base also. Why? Because this is important. Okay, so how we are doing is we are starting with the base and then we are taking it closer to our napkin, and you can see that wherever we had done the seal work, it looks very much natural there. Now with a cloth, I will just take up all the excessive colors on the parts where I don't want to highlight. And this looks so complete now. what I'm doing is here I have taken up my water with my acrylic color and I'm just trying to blend it as much as I can. And once I'm happy with this, I will just smudge it on the sides too. And the moment I'm done with this, I am going to use my heat gun. Okay. Thank you so much for your kind words and I'm so happy that I was able to help you in learning this technique. I'm still learning. I am still trying my hands every day on this. And like I say, I do make mistakes. I make huge and blunder mistakes. But I love it. And if you love this, then do try this out. This is really going to help you in creating something beautiful. Okay, now here we are done and this looks absolutely, absolutely beautiful. Let me just finish this. So now, I hope this is all visible on the camera. If you guys have any query, please do let me know in the comment section. And yes, I'm just spreading this a little more on the sides so that this looks much more natural. Okay, now this is done. This is absolutely done. I'll just finish up this part. Okay, and this is almost done. Now what we are going to do is we will be using our heat gun. And yes, we have some really nice and different stamps which we are going to use. So yes, Massive has launched few more designs on the stamps and we will be using that on this video too. Wherever you feel that you need to add some color, please do not hesitate. Do try this out and that's how we all learn. Okay? I think I will skip the stamping part for now. And once I'm happy with this, then I'm going to seal this up with my varnish. Now for the varnish, like I mentioned earlier also, I'm going to use my water-based varnish and let me try if I can use my stamp now. Okay, so these are few of the stamps which I absolutely love and let me try this square. This is one of my recent favorites which I have been using for quite a good time now. So let me choose a color which I want to have. Okay, I think I have decided. So today everything is being so quick. Now let me take up some of the color here in the palette. Now with a paintbrush, I will just brush it up on my stamp. Okay, and now I will be doing this on my chalkboard. Just press it, do not press it too much, just a bit of stamping work with your chalk paint. And can you see that? This looks gorgeous, such a beautiful pattern. And now I will be repeating the same for the other side. Let me take another brush. Okay, so here I will take my chalk paint. Let me try this with, okay, I'll use this broader brush. This is going to help me in having a bigger space spreading and I'm going to repeat the process here. Okay, just a bit of texture work. This is just to break the monotony of the stripes because what I felt was there was too much of stripe work. And now I will be doing my chalk paint work on these complete stamps. This is just to make sure that I have good amount of checkered pattern on my board. And this is, like I said, you don't have to use your stencils every time and that's the reason I love these stamps from Massive. And yes, the links are mentioned in the comment section. You can check that. And if you guys have any query, you can ping us anytime. And we will try to reply back as soon as possible. A bit more of my chalk paint. And then I think we will be done. So here what I'm doing is, here I'm applying my chalk paint on my stamp, the massive stamp. These are the heavy duty stamps which can be used with your chalk paints. The only thing you need to be careful is that you need to clean it up very immediately once you have used it. And this looks gorgeous. This looks super, super, super gorgeous. Now let me just varnish some of the colors here and there. And yeah, we are almost done. So yes, with this our session is done, and this looks absolutely gorgeous. So the actual board was this. What we have created is this. And once this dries out, I am going to cover this up with some nice thread work, and I will be posting that within a day or two. And I really, really hope that you all enjoyed this session. What we have created today is a chalkboard, and yes, what you need to make, all these are the very, very basic supplies of decoupage. And yes, the moment you are done with this, you need to seal this up. Now my colors are so wet that I cannot use my varnish here right now, but once this is done, I am going to varnish this with my water-based varnish. And yes, of course, I am listing down all the supplies the moment I am done with this session. If you guys have any queries, please do comment below. And thank you so much for watching. And yes, do not forget to check our website www.growingcraft.com. And of course, you need to check our YouTube channel. That's in the name of Growing Craft, where we have more than 500 videos. And yes, if you create something beautiful like this, then you need to show this to us on our Facebook group. And we would love, love, love to see your work. And thank you so much for watching, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.